Hello folks, this is Ayatan Anjha from InspireToRise.com and today we are going to talk about the Realme 3 Pro. So guys, the Realme 3 Pro is the latest smartphone by Realme, which is a sub-brand of Oppo, and it's an independent brand right now. Let's first start with an unboxing of the same. Inside you get the TPU cover for this one, you get the quick start guide, the warranty card, and inside you get the smartphone itself. We have this specific dark color, and inside you also get the VOOC charger for this one, 5V 4A charger, and there's the micro USB to USB type A cable. This cable is really thick. The VOOC charger takes very less time to charge this device completely. It's almost as fast as the dash charging mechanism seen on OnePlus devices. Now let's talk about the build and design. It's got a polycarbonate back with a shiny finish, and at the back there's a dual camera sensor along with a fingerprint sensor. At the top there's the water drop notch and there's the earpiece. At the bottom there's a slight chin, and if you look carefully at the bottom there's a 3.5mm jack, still just a micro USB port, no USB type C, a speaker grill and a microphone, and on the right hand side there's the power button for this one. Overall it could have been a little bit thinner. On the left there's the volume rocker and it has got a dedicated micro SD card slot, and on the top there's the noise cancellation microphone. The plasticky build does feel a little cheap and it could have been more premium if it had glass body, and it has a 6.3 inch full HD plus IPS display with Corning Gorilla Glass 5 protection. The display angles are good and contrast, sharpness, saturation, etc. Everything is on point. If we talk about the specifications, it comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 710 chipset. The variant that we used was a 6GB RAM, 128GB storage, highest end variant. And out of that, you get around 106GB free. It supports USB OTG and it has got a great GPU and it has almost every sensor that you need for a great smartphone experience. There's no NFC. It scored above 150,000 on the AnTuTu benchmark, which is a respectable score. It has got good performance, and on the Geekbench also the numbers were really good. Not as high as the Snapdragon 675, but good, and in the internal storage is really fast and you get around 287 Mbps read-write speeds. If you talk about the gaming performance, this smartphone is one of the few in its segment to support Fortnite, and it comes with Realme Game Space. Fortnite support is also coming to the Xiaomi Redmi Note 7 Pro soon via an update, but right now it works on this device on medium settings and the game is really playable. No issues, no lags whatsoever, and my first gameplay experience on this device was good. If I talk about PUBG, you can play that on high settings, and HD and high graphics is possible on this device. Overall, the experience was good and gameplay went on for hours and hours. And one thing that I did was I played for a long period of time in order to test whether the smartphone would heat up or not, because something like the Xiaomi Redmi Note 7 Pro heats up when you play PUBG at high settings for a really long duration of time. And in my experience with this smartphone, the heating was not so much, but as you can see, the gameplay went on for quite some time, and even after this match finished we played two more matches. And let's just move forward, and Grand Theft Auto San Andreas was also playable on this smartphone on highest possible settings. If we talk about the heating performance, we were in a temperature controlled environment, and there the smartphone heated up to 35 to 36 degrees Celsius on the display, and at the back also just up to 34 or 35 degrees, so the heating was negligible to say the least. And it does not heat up as much as the Xiaomi Redmi Note 7 Pro comparatively. Now let's talk about the camera for this device. It comes with a Sony IMX519 sensor, the same which was seen on the OnePlus 6 and the 6T, and it's a great sensor. And if we talk about the camera UI, it supports automatic scene detection. There are a lot of modes. There's also 1x, 2x, digital zoom, etc., expert mode, nightscape mode. There's also slow motion. 4K video recording is supported on this device, and 1080p 60fps videos are also supported on this device. If I talk about the images, they were quite good, had a lot of detail, sharpness, saturation was a little bit higher. And if I talk about the selfies, the portrait mode edge detection was not that great, but I can say that the detail is certainly on point and the colors really pop out on the images, which is something that I personally like a lot, and you can see the quality for yourself. And overall I felt that the camera is really solid on this device. It supports EIS and the 4K videos were stable enough even with high level of shaking, and I felt that the detail in those videos was good. The 1080p videos shot from the front camera also look good. They have good dynamic range. But if I talk about something like stabilization, it was not really that great. It has full support for camera to API, and I was easily able to install a working version of Gcam, and you can see all of the Gcam samples now. So I zoomed in quite a lot into all of these Gcam samples in order to find out how sharp images I was getting, and needless to say, With Gcam installed on this one, you can get really detailed images. So I feel that they have done a great job with the camera for this device. Wide 1.11 support is present on this device, so you can watch content on Netflix in HD. And if I talk about the software experience and user interface and user experience, so it comes with ColorOS latest version based on Android Pie. It's good enough for normal usage and does not have ads like MIUI. It has some bloatware applications which can be removed easily. And if I talk about the video watching experience, full screen videos are supported on this device, which is good. And now let's do a small audio test. The maximum audio output was good enough, and this smartphone does have a lot of other features which make for the shortcomings, but it does have a fast fingerprint sensor when compared to a lot of other smartphones out there, and it also has fast fingerprint as well as face unlock. The battery on the inside is a 4000 mAh plus battery. It easily lasts more than a day if you are an above average user too, and if you're somebody who's into really heavy gaming, then also you would like it. Expected price is just around 14,000 rupees, and I believe that it would be even lesser because these guys seriously want to undercut the Xiaomi Redmi Note 7 Pro. It does have few cons compared to that phone, like the design is not that premium. Just like the Redmi Note 7 Pro, it does not have carrier aggregation support, which is LTE Plus, and then there are few other things, few other shortcomings. The ColorOS experience is something which is a shortcoming, micro USB port and few other things which kind of diminish the superlative experience that the smartphone provides. But still, for the price, I believe it's a good phone. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and do subscribe to Inspire to Rise for more awesome tech videos like this one. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise.